Did you, when you were coming up in New York, did you get offered like a shit ton of money to do some like album cover and you like turned it down?
Yeah, man.
You got offered like almost like $100,000 or something.
$70,000.
70 grand. And you said no.
I said no.
Why?
So I can't tell you who it was.
Okay.
I'll tell you guys off the air.
Okay.
But it was this
well-known
musician.
Okay.
Wanted me to do his album cover. It started off at 10 grand. Mm. I had already knew in my head that I didn't want to do it.
Okay. I was
like, there's no way I'm doing that.
But you were broke at the time, right?
Yes, sir. So I was like, there's no way I'm doing that. I was like, but let me see how much I could get it up to. So I was like,
just for fun.
I was like, that ain't enough. I was like, that ain't enough. And then it kept going up to up. And I was like, nope, still not enough. And it got up to $70,000. And then I was like, nah, I'm not doing it. Like, and I was straight dead broke at the time, like for real, like $5 a day in New York City, like living off $5 a day. And the reason I didn't do it is because I think of my fans.
Mm-hmm.
And I think of what they would think if I did something like that.
Okay.
I think, what if a dude that I looked up to did some shit like that? How would I feel? And I'm like, nah, that shit ain't, it don't add up. And so basically it got up to $70,000. I turned it down. And the reason I turned it down is because it would have been the last money I ever made, I think.
Mm.
You know, I do that shit and then fools are like, that fool is weak. Like,
sold out right away.
Oh cool, he did the fucking album cover, he made all this cash, we ain't buying his shit no more. That's the last money I would have ever made.
Did you turn down that kind of money though? That takes some fucking balls, bro.
Yeah,
that's crazy. So
you were just playing with him at that point though.
Yeah, and then
find out his worth.
Yeah. So now when somebody asks me if they're like, you want to do an album cover, I'm gonna tell them, I'm like, well, turns out $70,000 is my going rate.
Yes.
But I don't even do album covers like that because it's just a fucking thumbnail on your iTunes anyways. Album covers ain't even what it is and what it was anymore.
Yeah. But back then though, was it CDs and shit?
There would have been a couple CDs and shit, but it was like on the internet.
Mainly internet shit.
But yeah, I turned it down and then this other artist ended up doing it who I looked up to. And he did it, and then I was like, that dude's weak now.
Oh,
I was like, he's same cut. Shit
that you thought you were
exactly.
Now.
Wow. I was like, that dude's cut. I can't believe he did that shit. Did you find out how much shit. He made? Probably not as much as I got.
he probably did it for 10.
Yeah. But,
who, I mean, like, were you tripping out this person even reached out to you in the first place? You're like, I don't even like your shit.
You know what? When stuff like that happens, I can't be like, I don't like your shit, so don't like my stuff. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like
true,
my shit's for everybody.
Right.
It's like, you know, I got these two dudes in Texas that are a gay couple, and they got a bunch of my shit.
Mm.
And it's like, I don't care who buys my stuff. Like, you like it, you like it. Like, mm-hmm. It's all yours. Like, there's a lot of artists out there, like fine artists and shit, who are like, no, you can't have that
in your collection.
Yeah, and I'm like, fuck that, dude. Like, I ain't there to judge somebody, like, right. You know, like, I don't want my stuff in your house. If you like my shit, then you like my shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, this dude hit me up and then, I turned down 70 grand when I was dead broke, and it was a smart move.
Yeah.